Good morning, Hebrews. Welcome back to class. This morning we are looking at RMV. I repeat, our subject is RMV, and it's just for basic 5 alone. And the topic said unity in cultural diversity. I repeat myself, unity in cultural diversity. But before we proceed to unity in cultural diversity, we have to know what is the meaning of culture, unity, and diversity. We all know that culture is a total way of life of a set of people living in a particular area. For example, we know the Igbos, they have their own culture. The Yorubas, they have their own culture. The Hausas, they have their own culture. Just like we used to say that when a Yoruba man wants to greet his elderly one, he does what? He prostrates and greet. And when a Hausa man wants to greet his fellow Hausa man, he squats to greet. That is what we mean by culture. And for example, if you come to the Igbo land, you will see them eating Akpu and Ohasu. When you come to the Yoruba land, you see them eating Ewedu and Amala. When you come to go to the Hausa, you will see them eating Tuwo Shinkafa. And then let's know about unity. What is the meaning of unity? Unity means to be one. Unity means to agree to one thing. It said it refers to the state of feeling or being one or being joined in one group and agreement. Unity means to be together, to agree to one thing, irrespective of where you are coming from. Now, what is diversity? I hate this word. Diversity refers to the state of being different from each other. For example, I will not do with something with you. You are a Yoruba. I will not be with you. You are an Igbo. No, it's only Yoruba I talk to. It's only Igbo I talk to. Now, let's look at unity in cultural diversity. What is unity in cultural diversity? You say unity in cultural diversity refers to oneness in spite of differences in cultural background or ethnic group. Yes, it means coming together, forgetting that you are Yoruba, forgetting that you are Hausa, forgetting that you are Igbo, forgetting that you are from Calabar. When you come together, you agree to one thing. If I tell you, they used to say, divide, united we stand, divided we fall. So as one Nigeria, we must come together. As one Nigeria, we must always come together. We must always promote other people's culture, not just our culture. Ways of promoting unity in cultural diversity. I go again. What are the ways we can promote unity in cultural diversity? We can promote cultural diversity by what? Making friends with mates who are not from our ethnic group. Making friends with mates who are not from our ethnic group. Yes, I'm a typical example of that. I have Yoruba friends. I have Hausa friend. I have Shola as my friend. I have Benga as my friend. And I have Ibrahim, he's from Kaduna, as my friend. And we play together. We laugh together. We live in peace. In fact, there are some my Yoruba friends that will go to the house and will sleep in the house for 1 week, 2 weeks. I will relax there. I will feel at home. It's always good. And then we move to number two. Number two said, eating foods from other people's culture. You know me very well, Mr. Fuwa is an Igbo man, but I love eating a wet amala and baby with soup with, you know, some Israel or buffet, you know, putting it. I love eating it a lot. And when I see it, I love it. And I've seen some Yorubas that love eating oha soup with apple. I've seen them. I've seen some Yorubas that love eating Edikayikon soup. That is the soup from Calabar. They love it. For me, bring it when you bring it. Maje, I will eat it. Wearing dresses from other cultures. I would have bring in my buba today. I have buba if you don't know. Wearing dresses from other cultures. It can also promote unity and cultural diversity. Learning to speak languages of other ethnic groups, not just your language. It's very good for you to learn how to speak other people's language. For example, when you go to a typical village where they don't understand English and you know their language, in fact, when you get there, it will be easy for you. Just for me, like for example, now I go to Ogun State and I don't know my way. I would just, if I know that the mama I saw that cannot speak English, I'll just go, mama, I can't solve, maybe no, more one or more one be by, I've spoken Yoruba, and mama will say, I'm going to be da, okay, him be by, egg by me. So that is it. But because I have tried to learn the language, it is very good to learn other people's language. Don't just stick on your own. My own, it's only me, but I will learn. Try to learn other people's language. It is fun, and it will help me in future. Number five, the last but not the least, being truthful in your interaction with people, not minding their ethnic background. Don't say because it's a Yoruba, I will cheat him. I used to tell you guys a story. that it's, you don't even know when your love will come. I used to tell you guys a story. Let me repeat the story. I used to tell you that when I was training as a catcher, one day I was coming back from catching school, and then I want to buy a banana. The woman don't know me. When I asked how much is banana, what she told someone sitting close to her side, she said, you get joining a buy go. You know what that means in English? She said, you will use me, you will sell banana costly for me. Not for him, I was Igbo. If she thought I was Yoruba, then do you know what I responded? I responded with Igbo. I said, when you keep get cheap, buy go. Meaning, who will you use and make money? You will sell banana costly with me. Madam, and how much I sell it? You see, do you know what happened? Because of that, what she said, I left her market. You know why? She was trying to cheat me, not knowing that I understand what she said. So we need to be truthful, irrespective of the people we are dealing with, whether they are Hausa, whether they are Calabar, whether they are Delta, whether they are Igbo, whether they are Yoruba. Be truthful with them, interact with them. You don't know where we'll meet ourselves tomorrow. It's very good to help yourself together. Don't say, hey, my mother said I should not play with Yoruba. Hey, it's a lie. Play with Yoruba. Don't say, hey, they said that Hausa people are very wicked. Who told you so? Even the Igbos, they have wicked ones, and we have the good ones. I believe we all understand, and I'll send your assignment online. See you same time next week. God bless you. Please remember to always read your book, not to play much. Read much and play less. Thank you.